who are continuously joining.
Okay, wait. Actually, I also don't know about in
Okay,
Google Meet how
leave
to
it.
do.
Leave it. So, students, I am also live on YouTube. I hope you can see the screen. Do you see? No, I have not shared the screen, so you will not able to see. So, share. Here on YouTube, you can see I am live. Okay, so let's move to our syllabus. So here we have this syllabus in our course in fourth semester, the fluid mechanics lab first and so as you see in the syllabus, what is the objective? To impart the knowledge and of flow measurement, to give an idea of pressure variation of fluid in a pipe, and to give an idea of dynamic behavior of a fluid. So mainly we will try to cover second part in today's discussion. Then what will cause you to what is the motivation behind going through all these experiments? So this is the motivation, practical measurement of flow rate. You are able to measure the flow rate. Then pressure, friction in a pipe, it can be done through this laboratory. So discharge, this becomes pressure and pressure losses, friction in pipe. When we are able to calculate the pressure drop, then based on that, we will be able to calculate the friction in a pipe. So these are the outcomes where CO1 investigate pressure variation, fluid behavior and losses along the flow through a circular pipe. Then CO2 compare actual and standard cavitation number of a fluid flow and test the validity of the Bernoulli theorem along a convergent divergent section. Then determination of coefficient of discharge, third point CO3, contraction coefficient of velocity flow through flow rate using rotameter, and CO4 is determined force exerted on a curved bench by impact of Z. Then last CO5 is compare surface profile of a forced vortex. In today's lecture, this part will be covered, CO1. So what are the list of experiment? As you can see, determination of cavitation number, then Bernoulli equation for incompressible flow, definition of coefficient of discharge, coefficient of contraction for office meter, surface profile of vortex apparatus and determination of friction losses in pipe. So today we will cover fifth experiment, determination of friction losses in pipe. Okay, so let's have a quick view. As per your class teacher information that he has shared these notes with you. If you can see these notes, so he told me that he talked about the losses in pipe. So what we are going to measure here in measure losses, as you can see, measure losses depends on pipe wall friction and friction.
Hello sir, not visible. The notes are not visible.
Wait a minute.
Now, first two syllabus is open. Yes, now it is visible.
Student, if it is not visual, then you should inform immediately. So here, in as per information, this notes I have got. Wait a minute. So in experiment number 5, we will measure the losses in friction, 5 friction losses. So mainly friction losses consist of two types, major and minor. And major losses is due to the pipe wall friction and friction between the fluid layers. So due to this one is viscosity and due to the roughness. First one is due to the roughness. So in this experiment, we will cover this part, and this one is minor losses. As you can see, minor losses are like at this point, at bend, and then at when there is a wall on that position. Okay, so just a quick view. These are the parameters under which velocity proportional of fluid it depends on Darcy-Weisbach equation, that is frictional resistance, and as you can see, it is independent of pressure and nature of surface in contact. That means nature of surface in contact means surface roughness. So assumptions, and he has discussed that let's consider two points here, 1 and 2, and these are the P1, V1, Z1 value, P2, 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 V2, and Z2 value. Cross section area same, so based on the discharge is constant. So,
sir, we can skip this part because today I covered this. So,
okay,
I think
so. Let's
just recently at 2 hours back, I covered this topic, so not required, I think.
Here
we can go for experiment.
Here we will use this formula for calculating the this factor, Darcy-Weisbach friction factor, and that is, as you know, that 4F dash when it is used, it becomes a Darcy-Weisbach factor from here. So, and F dash is the coefficient of friction. So let's move to our experiment. So when you visit this website, let me show you full screen.
Sir, the screen is not visible.
Wait a minute. I hope now this is visible to you.
Yes, sir.
So, visit this lab. www.vlab, V for vehicle. VLab, I want to write the name, but let me show you here. वी लैब डॉट को डॉट इन नोट इट डाउन. सो इट इज फॉर वर्चुअल लैब को डॉट इन ऑब्वियसली डब्ल्यू 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 डॉट ऑल दीज आर स्मॉल वी लैब डॉट को डॉट इन. सो वेन यू विल विजिट हियर यू विल कम टू दिस पेज एंड हियर इन दिस पेज यू विल फाइंड द दिस वन. वेन यू विजिट द वी लैब वर्चुअल लैब सो ऑन दिस पेज you will find
sir screen is not visible.
It should be visible.
The lab screen is not visible, sir.
So it is visible.
Visible, it is visible. I think there is a problem in your network. Just check.
So here
yes sir, now it is visible.
Okay, so here in mechanical engineering lab there are other various lab, but for our experiment we need to move in civil engineering lab. Note it down, because each experiment is in different lab. So here in civil engineering lab we will move, and here you can see fluid mechanics. There are various other labs. So here you will see fluid mechanics, and it was developed by NIT Suratkar. So let's move to the so we are here in fluid mechanics lab. So this is the introduction and experiment part. These are the list of the experiment. You can see the calibration of V notch, calibration of rectangle notch, impact of the friction in pipes, and venture meter. So second last is friction in pipe is our experiment. Okay. So as I discussed about the various types of losses, so just discuss about losses, and mainly what you need to understand that here pipes losses are dependent on number of factors like viscosity of the fluid. Remember, if you can underline it or note it down in short, depends on number of factors like viscosity of the fluid, the size of the internal pipe diameter, the internal roughness of the inner surface of the pipe, the change in elevation between the ends of the pipe, material of the pipe, and length of the pipe along with the fluid travels. So these are the important parameters when we go for the considering the friction losses. Next is listen. Pipe with smooth surface do not occur for larger friction loss. If the surface is smooth, the friction loss is not a major part in that. Whereas pipe with less smooth walls such as concrete, cast iron and steel fluid requires a large energy to overcome the friction induced in the pipe due to the viscosity of the liquid. Conclusion is, rougher the inner wall of the pipe, more will be the pressure loss due to the friction. Now, you can consider these are inner wall, this side and this side. So this one is smooth and this one is rough. As you can see, pressure drop in smooth pipe is less, as you can see. And here pressure drop in,
I think sir, it is not visible. Actually the side is visible only.
Oh,
what you are doing,
yes, sir.
That is not visible.
It's
visible in YouTube,
sir. Yes, now it is visible. So, okay. So, in conclusion, what I discussed, that pipe with the smooth surface do not occur for larger friction loss. It means the if smoother pipes are, inner surfaces are smoother, then that will not account for large friction losses. Whereas pipe with less smooth walls such as concrete, cast iron, or fluid, steel fluid requires large energy to overcome the friction induced in pipe due to viscosity of the fluid. So rougher the this important line, rougher the inner wall of the pipe, more will be the pressure loss due to the friction, as you can see. So this one and this one. This one is smooth, this one is rough. So here, as you can see, in a smooth surface, pressure drop along the diameter negligible, and in this one, rough pipe, as you can see in the middle one. So overall effective diameter is reduced. So pressure drop is in the range 0 to 1 by 2.4. So and rough pipe, you can see in the porous medium, when it is porous medium, you can see the pressure even more. So conclusion is the pressure drop depends on the roughness of inside surface of the pipe. So sir has also told you probably that laminar flow range is below 2100 Reynolds number, then turbulent flow Reynolds number should be in this range, and transitional flow Reynolds number should be greater than 4000. So from that, like I told you, that the head loss due to friction is calculated on the basis of Darcy equation, that is also Darcy-Weisbach equation. That is theoretical equation that predicts the friction loss, energy loss in a pipe based on the velocity of the fluid and the resistance of due to the friction. It is used almost exclusively to calculate the head loss due to the friction in turbulent flow. This one, especially, it means directly you this equation for the turbulent flow, calculating the head losses. So there are other factors we need to consider. Let's suppose HF is the friction head loss, F is a Darcy resistance factor, that is 4F dash, length of the pipe, pipe diameter, mean velocity, acceleration due to gravity. And now here two parameters you can see. Based on this Moody chart, as you can see, K is the turbulent flow, the factor, friction factor F depends upon the Reynolds number and the relative roughness of the pipe. It means K by T. K is the roughness parameter. So, as you can see, relative roughness, so D is the constant, but K varies from one pipe to another pipe. So, it's smooth. Pipe K would be less, for rough pipe this roughness parameter, that is in simple term you can say average roughness K is more in rough pipe. So K by T, that is the relative roughness of the pipe. So based on that, this Moody graph has been drawn. As you can see, this side on left side, y-axis, frictional coefficient F is, then here Reynolds number on the x-axis, and this side K by D, but it is not shown here, right side on y-axis, K by D. Instead of showing K by D on right side, they have shown K by D ratio values. You can check. Actually, it is, I want to show you here. on this Moody chart. After the class, you can also download the Moody chart and you can check on this axis the friction coefficient, Reynolds number, and this axis K by D, that is relative roughness, is given. And based on that, this chart has been drawn. So, at this one is the range for when Reynolds number is under 2100. So, laminar flow, and then beyond transition from here. From here, turbulent to laminar transition happens in this range, and after that, in this region, we are using two types: rough pipe and smooth pipe. So, from here, 0.08. From this line, from here to this side. For the smooth pipe and above is when KYD is 0.03, in between to 0.016. This range is for fully rough flow. So it is for rough pipe. So this was all about theory. Now, self-evaluation. So there we will have a question. So Darcy-Weisbach equation is HF is equal to, there are four options, which one is FL square by, if you remember you can tell me.
So B.
FLV square by 2GD. Who gave the answer?
B, second one.
So this one is, let's check right answer. So next question, we will have five questions here. Under otherwise uniform condition, fanning friction factor for a rough pipe is, it is greater than that of a smooth pipe. So this one is maybe out of your question, this discussion, but for let me do it for you. So fanning factor for a rough pipe is greater than for a smooth pipe. So this one is right answer. Next, now here you have to answer this question. Which of the following is wrong? Glass and plastics pipes have less friction losses. Cast iron steel pipes have high friction losses. So if you remember, this point, pipes with smooth surface does not account for large friction losses, whereas pipes with less smooth walls such as concrete, cast iron and steel flow requires large energy to overcome for the friction induced in pipe due to viscosity of the flow. Rougher the inner wall of the pipe, more will be the pressure drop due to friction. So we are at this page. Glass and plastic pipes have less friction loss. True or false? Option first, tell me it is true or false.
This true, sir.
See, glass and plastic pipes obviously have the smooth surface, internal surface. Okay, so less friction loss. Again, as discussion, you saw that cast iron steel pipes have high friction loss. True. Both are true or not?
Yes, sir.
So this option one is incorrect. Option one and second is not our choices. Then both are wrong. That is also incorrect. So both one and second, one word is missing. Both and one and second are correct. It should be this one. Let's check this one. Right answer. Next, a flow in which each liquid particle does not have a defined path. It means path is not defined and the path of individual particles also cross each other is called turbulent flow. It is true or false? True. Let me check. Correct answer. Okay. Minor losses do not make serious effect in. Okay, tell me the condition of minor losses. So,
short pipes.
Wait a minute.
Short pipe for short length.
Wait a minute. So minor losses based on only this factor. See, expansion, contraction, bend, or when there are some when pipes are joined or valves are used. So these contribute to minor losses. Okay. So now again here. Minor losses do not make serious effect in short pipe, long pipe, both the pipes, none of these. Long pipe means what? Short pipe means small length. Long pipe means straight pipe. That is less number of bends, or you can say less number of bends, obviously. Expansion, contraction, like this. So what should be the our option?
B.
Long pipe. Should I check it? Tell me. Should I check the answer?
Yes, sir.
Correct answer. So we have finished this part also. So procedures. Objective is to determine friction in pipes. So you can also visit on FM lab, or sorry, virtual lab, vlabs.co.in, and then you can read this step by step. I am explaining it although. So here in that procedure, they have explained everything. So first step, open friction pipe experiment, a window will appear as shown when you go for the virtual lab experiment. Then here you will find the objective to determine the friction pipe. Apparatus is, what are the apparatus? The pipe having different diameter, connected to a different manometer, a collecting tank, stopwatch, and scale. So these are the, this is the setup. You need a storage tank, you need a manometric differential manometer, then this pipe arrangement, then this valve, obviously you will need. So here next you will click here, not here, when you go for performing the simulation, then you will click here. okay, lower right corner on this symbol. Here they are explaining the average steps. So next, then select the required known diameter of the pipe, then click next button. Let me also check one by one. Here this step. So simulator. Before that, first step, click here, click. Next step is saying, select the pipe of the required diameter. Here it is saying, select the pipe of the required diameter. So we will select pipe of required diameter. What should be our diameter? 50? We can select anyone. See here, 50 mm, 40 mm, 25 mm, 20 mm, 15 mm diameter. Okay, so we can select anyone. Okay, let me select this 50 mm diameter pipe, the top one. Okay, length of the pipe is 3 meters. After this, click on the selected pipe inlet valve to allow the flow through it. Whatever we have selected, we will click on the selected pipe inlet valve to allow the flow through it. Okay. So we have selected 50 mm diameter pipe. Next step, we will see here arrow mark is showing, so we will click here and we are ready. Next, here it, after that, click on the main inlet valve to allow the flow through it, and then click on the pipe valve to allow water flow through. As you can see here, this one is a storage tank, okay, and water is coming along this direction, and here inlet valve, and then in five pipes water is going. So each pipe has a valve. So after opening or closing the valve, it will allow water to flow. So rest four valves are closed and only top one is open. That is, we have selected 50 mm diameter pipe. So first this one will be opened, and then we will allow to open this one to allow the flow of water. So we are here at this stage. So we will click here. So it is open, and when it is open, water is flowing. So trial one, you can see trial one is ready. Okay, so the main inlet valve is open to allow the water. Obviously we have done it. Then open the pipe valve and change the knot of the manometer from isolated position to air. So here we will have a knob like this, and we will allow to flow the water from this to in this manometer. Okay, we have done it. Then let me first here, after that it is stating that main inlet valve should be open. So we are doing it. Then isolated position, this one is isolated position, so we need to open it, and these two air vent position. So to escape the air inside from the differential manometer. So it is from isolated air position to air vent position to remove the air inside the pipe. We are ready here. Next is, now Change the knot to read position when the steady flow is reached inside the pipe. So we will wait at this position that there is no difference in manometric height, manometric fluid height. So when it is stable, then we will close this air vent. Now change the knot to read position when the steady flow is reached inside the pipe. Turn on the exit valve of the collecting tank to allow the water flowing inside the. So here we will click it. At present, this one is at which position? Air vent position. Now we will click it reading position. And after that, we will open it. So water is coming, flowing through this. So here from at this point and here at this point, total length is 3 meter. And we are collecting water in this storage tank. But same time, what we are going to do that we will read the height of the this water. Height of the water in this storage tank. That's why we have opened it. What will happen if we open this exit valve? All the tank will be empty. So at some point we need to fix the height. So equilibrium position, that is water in, coming inside the tank, is equal to water going out of the tank. So that state we need to achieve. Here. Okay. So we have reached this stage. Next is note down the manometer reading. Once this one is stable, we will note down the manometer reading and then reading in left limb. Water is coming from this side, so obviously in left limb, what due to high pressure, this
sir, limb, sir,
yes,
sir, screen is also now it is correct, sir.
Okay, as you can see,
sir, can I?
Sorry, you are not audible. Sorry, students, if you have any issue with the internet connectivity, maybe I am not getting your voices. So here, see what I am telling you, that after this opening and we have stabilized the water level in this storage tank, so that we have maintained the constant flow rate from here and here, so there is no rise in the water. At this stage, we will note down the reading in manometer reading. So left side, it will have the higher, lower position manometric fluid, and this side higher due to high pressure in left limb. So left limb reading, as this one is trial, so left limb reading it will show you as 22, and right limb reading it will show you 23. So head loss, okay, so here we are in trial 1. So what is the next step? To read the manometric reading in both limbs. So these are the limbs. So when we read and see this, this tap is open, exit valve is open. So left hand reading is note down because you have to calculate something. Note down left rim reading, because this one is going to trial 1, so everyone has to calculate it. Note it down. Left rim limb reading 33.5 centimeter, right limb reading 38.5. So head loss is 12.6 multiplied with difference in left right and left limb reading. So in these two reading,
sir.
Yes.
Sir, what is the formula of head loss?
Wait a minute. I am not focusing on how to write correctly. This here and here. These are the manometric fluid in this. So here you will read the reading left limb, and here you will read the reading right limb from top. Okay. So this one is delta x. You can say delta x. Or you can also say delta H, say delta X. Okay. And how to calculate pressure drop? Pressure drop due to flow, that is rho M minus rho divided by rho into change in height. So this one is delta x, that is the pressure drop formula. So for mercury it is 13.6, and this one is 1, 13.6 minus 1 divided by 1, and this delta x, that is ll minus rr, left limb reading minus. So overall what we will get, 12.6 multiply with change in this one, difference in reading, this value. I hope it is clear. So here when I click here, you can see 12.6 multiply with, see here, I hope it is visible. It in centimeter, 12.6 multiply with change difference in reading. So find out the value 33, and let me also calculate because I have to use in later. Trial 1 head loss 12.6 multiply with 38.5 minus 33.5, that is 5. That is total value becomes, use calculator. So here 30.6. Correct? Centimeter. Next, this one. Note it down, okay, 63. Then observation, trial 1, length of the pipe 3 meter, that is fixed, diameter of the pipe, whatever diameter we have taken 50 mm. So small d, 50 mm, area of collecting tap, that is fixed. Age 3500 centimeter square, that is also fixed. Head loss H, what we have calculated head loss, that is 12.6 multiply with the difference in limb, that is our head loss. So in our case, it is 63 centimeter. Then time taken, we have not calculated the time taken. So next step, we will calculate time taken T. So let's do it. Okay, so we cannot move ahead unless we enter the value here. So you tell me the value, then I will enter. Or tell me the value here. I have to enter here. Head loss formula is 12.6 difference in limb height. So this is the difference. What is difference? 5 mm. What value I should enter here?
113.4.
Which value?
113.4.
No, this one. If you are saying this one,
63
because we have taken the 50 mm diameter now. So for that 12.6 multiply with difference is what? In our case, trial 1, because we have taken this 50 mm diameter, height is, so only, it will accept only when we enter the correct value. See this, tick mark. So it is okay. Next, now we will close, because we have stabilized this reading, and we will close this exit valve. Collecting tank and time taken for tank water to rise by 10 centimeter is noted. So we, as you can see here, time taken should be noted. A rise in height is 10 centimeter would be recorded, and acceleration due to gravity g would be taken as a 981 centimeter, because all the value we are using in centimeter, so 981 centimeter per second square. So here again it is showing here, so we will close it. Closed. So it will record the time. So here initial reading 55 and final reading 65. So this reading is for what? Who can tell me? This reading is for what? For collecting tank. As you can see, scale is here. So scale, either there is an inbuilt scale on this tank, or we need to external scale. So as you can see here, we edge after closing the exit valve of the storage tank, we are collecting the water. So we are collecting the water for how much time? For we record the time and total height we record for 10 centimeter rise in height. Okay, rise in height 10 centimeter, and in that 10 centimeter height time required, it took the 35 second time. Note it down. Time 35 second, and rise in height was 10 centimeter. Okay, and now we have to perform the calculation. So Q actual, what is the Q actual? As you know, there are of a storage tank, storage tank. Cross section is there, and we are collecting the water for 10 centimeter height. So if we are able to multiply the cross section with height, we are able to calculate the total volume of the water. Correct? So discharges, volume flow rate. So total volume of water, what is the total volume? What is the cross section area of storage tank? That was the, if you remember, 3500 centimeter square. Multiply with the height and this one was, wait a minute, here, yes, we are going good. So time was 35 seconds. Calculate it. So 3500 multiplied with 10 divided by 35. So we are centimeter cube per second. Correct? So let's check it. Here we have to enter the value in the, as shown in the procedure. So we will enter the value here in coming section. So Q actual is based on this. These are the data in trial one. As we calculate 3500, height 10, or time 35. So I should enter 1000. Is it okay? I will go ahead only when you will speak. It is okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let me check. Correct. Now velocity. Now there is a question, how to find velocity? So again, as you can see, I cannot write here. Here. So as a top pipe is going to a storage tank, so we have calculated discharge actual, and that is discharge is also the same for the this pipe. Obviously it is for this pipe. So discharge Q, what is the discharge volume area into V? So we need to find velocity. So we will divide Q actual by A, cross section area of the pipe, and we will be able to get velocity. Correct? So V is equal to Q actual divided by cross section area of the pipe. So we are at this point. Second, to calculate the velocity. So we will calculate the velocity. Velocity, as you can see, velocity Q actual divided by cross section area here. Now calculate it. Q actual we calculated 1000 for trial 1, and cross section area pi by 4 d square. D should be in mm. Remember this, as it is in, sorry, it is in centimeter, so d should be also in centimeter. So pi by 4 and centimeter. So 5 is square, diameter becomes 5 centimeter. So calculate it. and tell me the answer. I'm ready. Based on this, calculate pi d square by 4, pi by 4 d square. Based on this, calculate on this formula. Actually, you have already calculated 1000, or d should be in mm. Oh, sorry, centimeter. Here 50 mm given, so centimeter. Based on this, tell me the answer. I have calculated. No, you have to tell me up to 4 decimal places.
Sir, it comes only this much, 80 calculation.
Let me write it. 50?
80.
80?
Yes, sir.
Check it again. कौन है ऑनलाइन प्रत्युत टेल मी इमीडिएटली व्हाट इज दिस वैल्यू प्रत्युत टेल मी सिंपल सर You have to count varies this much. Q actual 1000, pi d is 5 square by 4. You have to calculate only this. Tell me the answer. 160.
Yes, sir. Let me... I actually wrote 4.
40 mm.
No, sir. 160, sir.
Sir, 50.9554.
Let me enter 50.955. If it is okay, it will accept. Otherwise, let me show you if I am not writing. Okay. See this. It has accepted. If I write, even fourth place decimal place is wrong, it will not. It will show you as it incorrect. So analytical friction factor. How we will calculate? See here analytical friction factor. Based on this formula. Next step, HF, what is head loss is equal to, as we know, this one, this formula, as Sir has related. This one. Now, this formula we will use. So, head loss is friction coefficient of friction or torsion, respect coefficient, then L, V square, 2GT. So, based on this, on this formula, we will calculate F value. F is equal to 2GT V square into H by L. Now see what is the value of H. H is H head loss that we at the start calculated 63. And as you know, we every value is in centimeter, so G value should be in centimeter. 2 × 9081. Diameter of the pipe is 5 cm into manometric head 63 divided by V square. Ki, what is the value of V square? V is 50.9554 square multiply with L value. Length is 3 meter. So 3 meter in it means 300 cm. So calculate all these value and tell me the final value. I'm waiting for your answer. Somebody do it and tell me the answer.
Sir, 0.03967.
0.03967. What values you have used in your calculation? F is equal
to HL equal to
no. Okay, HL is equal to you have FLV square
63.
Upon. Wait a minute. HL is equal to FLV square upon 2GD. Based on that, F you have calculated same way 2GD. That formula it is showing here. 2GD by V square into H by L. Okay, so F for F, what you have used? 2 G value, what you have used? 981. So only one decimal place, and D value 5 cm, correct? And H,
yes, sir.
H value 63, and then L value length is 3 meter, so 300 cm. Check this, and V value we have velocity 50.9554 square. So let me write it for you. First, we know that head loss is equal to FLV square upon 2GD. Okay, correct? So, from here, we need to find out analytical friction factor. So, F becomes CF. 2GD divided by V square into head loss divided by length. So that formula we are using it. Okay.
Sir, 0.795.
So that formula we are using it here. So based on this one is 981, because in centimeter D is 5, H we have calculated 63, L is 3 meter, so 300 centimeter, and V square V value is 50.9554. So based on this, I have calculated this value. I am writing it here. This value is 0.7934. So I will check whether it is correct or not. So I will write here this tag. If it is okay, it will accept. Otherwise, we will check for any error. So 0.7934. Should I check? Correct. So this one is also okay. Next, again we have to repeat this step for three way. So trial 2, same way we have to open, then here knob, open position, then here air vent position. Okay, next here again static position when the limb is stable in this, so close reading position and open this one, then we will wait for water level to stable here. We will close this valve. Before closing, we will read the manometer reading. Okay. So now in trial 2, again we have selected the same pipe. So left limb head loss is how much? You calculate it. Head loss
126.
12.6 into 10, 126. Correct. Next, we will close it. We will record the time and for the rise of 10 centimeter. So initial reading 55, 10 centimeter high, required time to water to fill temperature 18 seconds. Note it down. H 10 centimeter, time 18 second. Okay. Now we have to calculate again. Actual we will calculate again because we are on storage tank. Total volume we have got 3500 multiply with the height, that is 10. So 35,000 divided by 18 second. What is that value? 3500 multiply with 10 centimeter height divided by 18 second. So you will get 1944.4444. Check. Correct. So velocity we will calculate Q actual divided by the cross section area of the pipe. So calculate the velocity. So multiply with so what is that value? Velocity 99.0799. We will check it. 99. 9.0799. We will check, it is also correct. So analytical factor, again calculate it. F is equal to 2981 multiply with the 2 GD diameter 5 and pressure drop height of pressure drop, manometric pressure drop was what we had calculated, 126 divided by velocity ka square. So 99.0799 square and multiply with again divide with length 3 meter, so 300 centimeter. So calculate it, 2 into 981 into 5 into 126, divide 300, again divide 99.0799, again divide 99.0799. So I have got 0.4197. I will enter 0.4197. Correct. Okay. So again, after that, trial 2. You have to do it again for trial 3 also. Same procedure you will follow. Okay. This one. This one. Next. Open. Next, here, head loss, calculate head loss in trial 3,
75.6.
Okay, I am not doing anything. Right now I will only enter your value, 75.6. Correct. Next, again we will close this one. We will take the reading for 10 centimeter rise of the water level. So 10 centimeter rise, time required 31 second. Note it down. Okay, we will use for actual discharge. Q is equal to cross section area of the tank and that is 3500, rise in water 10, so it become 3500 multiply with 10, this value use simple, A is 3500, H is 10, T is equal to 31 second. Based on this, tell me the value. I am not doing anything this time.
1129.0322.
Velocity, how we will calculate Q actual? We have already calculated, divide by the cross section area of the pipe. Okay, so tell me the value.
57.5303.
37.5303. Check. Incorrect.
Sir, 57.5. 57.
Okay. Correct. Next, analytical factor. Based on that, same formula, head loss formula you will use. Frictional loss formula. So formula for 2 टू जी डी वाई वी स्क्वायर एच एच बाई एल करेक्ट एवरेज एनालिटिकल फॉर्म फ्रिक्शन फैक्टर एफ इज कॉल्ड 0.57 ओके सो वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड simulator then we have done the procedure self-reflection simulator assignment so this define major losses in pipe define friction factor in the pipe this is the assignment now we come to the quiz check you are able to answer some of the question relevant to the simulation that you have used If the equivalent length of the 90 degree elbow is greater than 45 degree elbow, the pressure loss across 90 degree elbow is greater than equal to or less than or same as 45 degree elbow. So actually, equivalent length for 90 degree elbow and 45 degree elbow. So for 90 degree elbow, this one is equivalent length is greater. So for this pressure loss across the 90 degree elbow should be greater than the 45 degree elbow so answer should be this one okay now you tell me this question the loss of friction caused due to the bend coupling valves are
minor loss
correct answer next General formula used for calculating friction losses. Which formula? Friction loss.
Darcy-Weisbach.
Correct. Next, the head loss caused in straight pipe is straight pipe.
Major loss.
Okay, good. Last, for hydraulic smooth pipe, the resistance to flow depends only on the relative. See. First point, smooth pipe.
Reynolds number.
Relative roughness, absolute roughness, Reynolds number, relative roughness, and Reynolds number. So, Reynolds number only. Is it okay? Let me check. Wrong. Relative numbers and Reynolds number, both for hydraulic smooth pipe, the resistance to flow depends on. So, here in theory pipe based on the velocity of the fluid and resistance of the fluid. Somewhere it is in the theory. Okay, maybe it is not here. It is somewhere else. If you want to see then you can visit control labs there is a other lab not in food machines control virtual lab. So okay it is given in the control lab some the experiment of pipe flow. Okay, relative reluctance and Reynolds number. So here we finished it. After that, videos. No videos available. References for this, you can refer these books. So here your lab one completes. That is experiment number 5. Okay. Okay, if you have any query, you can ask me right now. You can try it for 50 mm, 40 mm, 30 mm, and calculate the coefficient of friction. Okay. So our syllabus was determination of frictional losses in pipe. So we determine the frictional head loss first in the form of head loss first. And then based on that Darcy-Weisbach equation, we found the value of Darcy coefficient, that is F. So based on that, we have already found the head loss. So that completes our this experiment, determination of friction losses in pipe. If you have any doubt, you can ask me here, you can ask me in the WhatsApp group also. Okay. And if you still need some discussion, you can discuss about any point with me or with your class teacher also. So I will stop here. And tomorrow we will see which lab we can go in morning session. Okay. So I'm stopping it here.